Sarah stared. The image staring back at her from the mirror didn't seem to offer any real consolation. She had thought that the activity of work would silence the refrain in her head, the one that was a chorus of sweet little cartoon birdies singing, "Ugly girl, ugly girl, ugly, ugly, ugly girl." This unpleasant tune had been a recurring theme in her head ever since she had won the film role as a character who apparently had no name and was known simply as Ugly Girl. She looked at her reflection and said, "You're not ugly, okay?" The reflection noticeably did not reply. Hi, I'm Neal A. Yeager, and today I'm reading from my novel, Non-Hollywood. If you're liking it so far, please subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications when I put new chapters up. This is actually one of my favorite chapters, chapter 15, Actress Equals Waitress. So it was back to work, and she was dreading heading back to table 12. Two guys, both large, both laughing too much to be completely sober, and one of whom was very, very loud. The two men also could not have appeared more redneck if they'd driven up on a tractor. The loud guy had already gotten into this running monologue, which he apparently thought was extremely funny, about the effeminate look of the restaurant's interior design. Basically, his line of so-called humor boiled down to the theory that the place must have been decorated by a gay man, as it was not only too effeminate for a straight guy, but also even too effeminate for a woman. Sarah tried to tell herself that at least this jerk took her mind off of the other thing. Of course, as soon as she thought that thought, the birdies piped up with another chorus of "Ugly girl." Sarah brought the order out to table 12. As she set the plates down, the loud guy said, "Hey, hon, can I ask you a question?" "Of course." The loud guy sported a look of exaggerated solemnity on his face as he asked, "Are you an actress?" Sarah replied, "Yes, I am." And the two guys burst out laughing, loud, obnoxious laughter that made several other customers turn toward table 12. "God damn," the loud guy shouted. "I knew it. I damn well knew it. I've been in this town for exactly 3 days, and each and every goddamn waitress calls herself an actress. That is a hoot." Sarah smiled politely. This was a difficult thing to do, as her mind held a vision of forcing her hand through the guy's temple, yanking out his puny brain, and showing it to him as he slowly died. "Well," she said, "that doesn't really surprise me." "Hell, man," the loud guy continued, "I'd always heard that, but I didn't know it was true. I thought it was just a joke." Sarah spoke calmly. "I think the word you're looking for is cliche, and well, some cliches happen to be true." The loud guy stopped laughing, looked directly at Sarah, and said, "No, actually, the word I was looking for was joke." And then followed a long pause. Until finally, Sarah said, "Okay," and walked away. She walked back behind the counter and over to where Mr. Grilled Cheese was seated at one of the stools. He was a regular, and though she knew that he had told her his name at least twice, she could only remember him as Mr. Grilled Cheese because that was the only thing that he ever ordered. He was nice. Well, maybe nice wasn't it. He was polite. He seemed a bit too somber for the label of nice. Let's just say that he was not a jerk, and that was good enough for this particular moment. Sarah leaned on the counter and asked him, "So, why is it that you only order grilled cheese?" He seemed startled at the sudden attention. Shy, definitely shy. "Well," he began, "I like the grilled cheese here. When I feel like grilled cheese, this is where I come. If I feel like something else, I go somewhere else." Sarah asked, "But why not try something else here? Have a burger, or the grilled chicken sandwich is really good." "I'm a vegetarian," he said. And Sarah noticed that he was blushing deeply. He stammered on, "Not that, I mean, I know that cheese is not a vegetable. It's just that I don't eat meat. It's stupid, I know." "No, it's not stupid. I hear it's much healthier to be a vegetarian." He smiled, an embarrassed-looking smile, and said, Well, not when you're eating grilled cheese and french fries and chocolate malts. She smiled and laughed. No, I guess that's probably true. She noticed out of the corner of her eye that the loud guy was waving to get her attention. Excuse me, she said to Mr. Grilled Cheese, and she walked back over to table 12. The loud guy asked her, So, do you consider yourself an actress or a waitress? Sarah took a deep breath and replied, An actress. Oh, man, said the loud guy, and he laughed and slapped the table. And you don't see that as a joke? No, I'm sorry, I don't. See, Winona Ryder is an actress, okay? Do you see Winona Ryder waiting tables? Angelina Jolie. Do you think Tom Cruise ever waited a table in his life? Sarah said, I have no idea whether Tom Cruise ever waited tables, but I know a lot of other actors who do. No, said the loud guy. You don't. You see, that's the joke that you're not getting. They ain't actors. They're waiters. Sarah prickled and said defensively, I'm an actress. I've got a role. I'm going to be shooting a movie soon. I'm going to be riding a jet ski soon. I don't mean I go around calling myself a jet skier. Sarah took a deep breath, then spoke calmly. Is there anything else I can get for you? The loud guy smirked and said, No, ma'am. Sarah walked back to the counter, where the clock basically screamed at her that there were 4 hours and 11 minutes to go. She noticed that Mr. Grilled Cheese's glass was nearly empty, so she poured him a refill and brought it over. As she turned to go, Mr. Grilled Cheese spoke up, though it was only to say, Sarah turned back to him. He seemed ready to say something. And Sarah found herself rifling through her memories to think of any occasion where this guy had actually been the one to start a conversation. He said, So, you've got a role. Sarah glanced back over at table 12. Had she been so loud that he had heard it all the way over here? God. Yes, I've got a role in an independent film. Wow, congratulations. What kind of part is it? Small, she said, and she relaxed into a laugh. It's small, but it's crucial to the plot, so it probably won't get cut. That's great, he said. And then he just stared at her. It was obvious that he wanted to say something else, but he didn't say it. Sarah said, Yeah, I hope it's... I heard you talking to Mary, he interrupted, the other day that you had, broken up with your boyfriend. Oh, she said, Yeah, that. As she paused, she once again saw the loud guy waving to her. Excuse me, she said. As she walked up to table 12, the loud guy said, Okay, so you say you know a lot of actors who wait tables. Okay, fine. Do you know any who did enough acting that they could quit waiting tables? Personally? No, she admitted. So far, I have not. The loud guy just smiled, spread his hands as if he had just demonstrated something profoundly obvious, and then he said, Okay, then. Sarah walked back over to Mr. Grilled Cheese. Oh, God, she said. That guy sounds like my old guidance counselor. She took Mr. Grilled Cheese's empty plate and asked him, So, what do you do? Me? I'm a writer. Oh, she said. That's interesting. No, he said. Not really. I'm a communications writer for an environmental engineering firm. And that's not interesting? Not really, he said. The money in that field is in cleaning up toxic mess. Remediation, they call it. It's all about hydrocarbons and effluent and such. And I'm the guy who's supposed to make all of that sound interesting. I really don't like it much. She asked, Is there something you'd rather do? He thought for a moment, then replied, Well, there's this place in Colorado. It's a zip line course. Being a zip line guide sounds like fun. Or maybe the Grand Canyon. What would you do at the Grand Canyon? Sarah asked. Wouldn't matter. Sell souvenirs, pick up trash. I don't care. Sarah thought about this. You know, she said, I hadn't thought of it before, but picking up trash at the Grand Canyon might actually be cool. And the two shared a smile. Mr. Grilled Cheese said, anyway, back to what I was saying before about your boyfriend. And as he trailed off, it clicked for Sarah that, my God, he was going to ask her out. But why? Why would he want ugly girl? And then he did it. I was wondering, he began, if, would you like to go out with me? Again, from the corner of her eye, she saw the loud guy waving at her. Oh, God, she said, and Mr. Grilled Cheese visibly winced. No, not you. It's the guy at table 12. I'll be right back, I swear. As she approached table 12, the loud guy said, one more question. You say you're an actress, not a waitress. Do actresses get tips? Sarah sighed and turned away without answering. He called after her, oh, come on now. She came back to the counter and said to Mr. Grilled Cheese, okay, here's the thing. It's too soon. Oh, he said as his eyes dropped to the counter. She continued, I swear, that's not just a polite avoid the question type of brush off thing. You seem nice enough, but it's really too soon. Ask me again in a month. He didn't look up at her, just mumbled to the counter, okay. Hey, she said, and stared at him. Stared at him until the heaviness of the pause made him look up at her. I mean it, don't get weird and stop coming here, and do ask me again in a month. He smiled shyly and said, okay. Oh, and one more thing, Sarah said. What's your name?